From a terrifying medieval church to the world's oldest mattress, here are 10 of the most amazing archaeological discoveries ever. Ancient Egyptian burials. Archaeologists in 2020 uncovered 13 fully sealed wooden coffins in the ancient desert necropolis of Saqqara in Egypt, with all 13 dating back to around 2,500 years ago. This desert necropolis is located about 19 miles, 30 kilometers, south of the city of Cairo, and it was a vast burial complex in its prime. According to a news report from Daily Mail, this was an ancient burial ground that served the old capital city of Memphis, and while there have been thousands of sarcophagi found all throughout the area, these new discoveries are unique in the fact that they have remained fully intact over the millennia. The coffins were found at the bottom of a 36-foot, 11-meter burial shaft inside the ancient necropolis. Experts analyzed the sarcophagi, which were so well preserved that the original colors could still be seen on the wood, and concluded that the burial caskets have not been opened since the original date of entombment. This is extremely rare for any discovery in Egypt, as there are often grave robbers who open tombs and steal the goods out of them before researchers get a chance to study them. Researchers believe the site at Saqqara had been used as a burial complex for 3,000 years, and that it was used by both the lower classes and the upper classes. Many of the more elaborate tombs have been found to contain lots of goods like silver, masks, and cartouches with hieroglyphs on them. As for these 13 new discoveries, only time will tell who exactly the coffins belong to. Tel Moza Temple. Out of anywhere on Earth, the land of Israel has been perhaps the most intensively studied place of all. But even so, there are still new discoveries being made all the time that completely astound researchers. For example, the site of Tel Moza has recently revealed even more wonders for archaeologists to investigate and study. Tel Moza is located about 4 miles, 6 kilometers, from Jerusalem in the Sorek Valley, and in 2012, archaeologists working for the Israel Antiquities Authority found a previously undiscovered temple that had been originally constructed in the year 900 BC. The temple had operated for hundreds of years and was only abandoned around the time of the Babylonian conquest. This is in direct opposition to what the Bible says, as the Bible claims that the only Judean temple at the time was in Jerusalem. However, this newest temple proves that's not true. It might be a little smaller than the Temple of Solomon, but it's still pretty big. The temple measures 33 feet wide, 10 meters, and about 60 feet long, 19 meters, and it would have existed directly in the heart of Judea, pretty close to Solomon's much more impressive temple. The discovery of this temple proves that throughout the later Iron Age period, many royally sanctioned religious temples must have existed. Despite the biblical narratives, temples did exist in Judah along with the official temple in Jerusalem. The most interesting part is that pottery figurines of men found at the site suggest the existence of a ritual cult, but what exactly that means in the scope of history is foggy at best. What do you think? Could this have been another Jewish temple? Perhaps an offshoot religion? Or could there be something more sinister going on here? Let me know what you think in a comment below. And this is important, remember to subscribe if you haven't already. Impressive new facts come out every day, and you don't want to miss any of these videos explaining them. Artifacts in the floorboards. There is nothing cooler than rare artifacts being discovered under an attic's floorboards. Inside an old Tudor manor in England, an archaeologist discovered a pretty interesting treasure trove. This was during a roof restoration project, as the ancient manor needed a serious overhauling of its roof. During the project, workers removed the floorboards in the attic of the estate for the first time in several centuries. After the floorboards were removed, there were all kinds of amazing artifacts discovered, all of which had apparently been hidden for hundreds of years. The main archaeologist working on the project uncovered over 2,000 antiques dating back to the 15th century. It's one of the most impressive archaeological finds of its sort, and it was as easy as lifting up some floorboards. Among the interesting discoveries was a nest built by rats out of scraps of Georgian silks, leathers, velvets, and satin fabrics. The rats had made a nest out of ancient clothes and scraps of paper from 450-year-old fragments of books and handwritten music. The manor was built in 1482 by a British nobleman named Sir Edmund Bedingfeld. To this day, his descendants still live in the impressive house. As devout Catholics, the family had been ostracized back in 1558 after Elizabeth I took the throne, since she was a Protestant queen and outlawed Catholic Mass. To save fellow Catholics, it's believed that the Bedingfelds hid holy men in their house house and participated in secret illegal Catholic masses. Now researchers can get a glimpse into the past with the well-preserved remains of this incredible 500-year-old mansion. Centaur skeleton. Have you ever wanted to see the complete skeletons of a centaur, cyclops, griffin, and unicorn? Well, you are in luck. The bones of an impressive centaur were put on display at Tucson's International Wildlife Museum in an interesting exhibit. You can find the entire skeleton of the centaur along with the skull of a griffin and the skull of a cyclops. These are not your everyday bones, however, they are obviously not real. The exhibit is entitled Mythical Wildlife, and it's designed to make people think about how we perceive what is real and what is not real. It also attempts to look at how some of our most interesting folklore could hold hidden scientific relevance. This is because mythology at one point was science. Centaurs were described in writing as early as 700 BC by a Greek poet, while griffins were discussed around 500 BC. The exhibit is a fun way to make people question the reality of science today and where the myths of monsters came from. For example, the myth of the Cyclops could have a lot to do with a prehistoric mastodon. This is because if you were to look at the skull of a mastodon tipped on its side, it could probably look like the skull of a one-eyed giant if you didn't know any better. The same could be said about the skull of a Protoceratops, which could have been the inspiration for the unicorn. Evidence of early humans. Some very cool archaeological discoveries have been made on a remote island in Indonesia that are providing vital clues about how people used to live 17,000 years ago. Stone tools, decorative beads, and animal bones were all found on the remote tropical island of Obi. One of the most interesting discoveries includes some of the earliest evidence of stone tool technology, stone ground axes dating back 14,000 years. This particular location is believed to be one of the starting off points used for the original Aboriginal people of the area to reach Australia. As you might already know, Australia was not populated from the beginning of humanity. Some humans who lived tens of thousands of years ago had to reach the continent over water. And it's highly likely that the first people to do that came from the islands of Indonesia. Axe heads from Poland. Far away from Australia and Indonesia, in Eastern Europe, a recent discovery of perfectly preserved axe heads shined some light on a battle that happened about 600 years ago. Two men went into battle with about 50,000 other soldiers, and all they left behind were two axe heads to tell their story. Archaeologists discovered these weapons while excavating a site in the north of Poland where one of the most intense battles of medieval Europe was fought. This is known as the Battle of Grunwald. Just imagine nearly 50,000 tired, angry, and vicious men fighting each other with axes, swords, and daggers. It didn't get much more brutal than that. There have been other weapons found in the area over the years, such as swords and spearheads, but these axe heads are in excellent condition. They were literally lying on the ground for 600 years before someone found them, and other than a bit of dirt, they look brand new. The Battle of Grunwald went down on July 15th in the year 1410 with Polish and Lithuanian forces allied against the German Teutonic Knights. Following an absolutely deadly fight, the Polish and Lithuanian forces defeated the Germans and either left the fighters dead on the battlefield or took them as war prisoners. This was the victory that allowed Poland and Lithuania to emerge as one of the most powerful states in Europe at the time. In fact, the site where the axe heads were found is a hugely popular tourist attraction, pulling in thousands of people from all over the world each year to see the location of one of the bloodiest battles in European history. Could you imagine fighting in an intense medieval battle like that? I don't understand how people did it. It seems like something straight out of a movie. What would you do if you were in one of those armies? Would you be able to fight like those men did over 600 years ago? Let me know in a comment below. Gruesome medieval church. This next archaeological discovery also comes to us from Poland, but it's a little more gruesome than the last one. Between 2018 and 2020, the bones of around 64 people, including men, women, and children, were removed from a 12th century church in Poland. This was done during some conservation work. The church is one of the oldest in the city of Gdańsk, and it had been closed in 2018 thanks to structural damage and the threat of collapse, and it was in the middle of the conservation effort in which the first set of bones were discovered in the walls of the church. After the initial discovery, more and more bones were found. According to an archaeologist on the site, they found mostly hand bones and forearm bones. But what does that mean? The evidence suggests that the people were buried during the early modern period, directly following the late Middle Ages. However, the bones were pretty broken up and difficult to date properly. Researchers were able to estimate the height of the residents of the town at the time, though, and it turns out that in the Middle Ages in Poland, women were about 5 foot 3 inches, 160 centimeters, and men were about 5 foot 7, 170 centimeters. After the church was repaired, they held a ceremony to bury some of the bones and the excavated items. A small wooden casket containing 3 skulls and a whole lot of bones was carried into the crypt of the church and put to rest. Remnants of Judean kings. Archaeologists in Israel recently unveiled an outstanding collection of column heads from the First Temple period. The stone artifacts are crafted from limestone and adorned with elaborate carvings, and they all come from the time of the old Judean kings. According to a CBN News report, the experts believe that the uncovered columns are remnants of an extensive mansion that at one point overlooked the Temple Mount and Jerusalem's old city. The pillar heads are carved with symbols that represent the ancient Jewish kingdoms of Judah and Israel, and it's the same symbol that is printed today on the 5-shekel coin in Israel. Archaeologists believe that the mansion that these perfectly preserved column heads belong to was built sometime between the reigns of King Hezekiah and King Josiah, which would have been after the Assyrian siege of Jerusalem in the year 701 BC. What makes the find especially strange is that while the column heads are perfectly preserved, the mansion itself is completely demolished. Still, the discovery gives a glimpse of what the city was like after the brutal Assyrian siege. It suggests that the city of Jerusalem began to grow following the First Temple period. Many villas, government buildings, and mansions were found in the unwalled areas outside the core of the city. This is a great testament to the roots and history of one of the greatest and most important cities of the ancient world. Bronze Age Cache. An amateur treasure hunter accidentally stumbled upon one of the greatest Bronze Age hoards in Scottish history. The man's name is Marius Stipion, and he was just exploring a remote part of Scotland with his metal detector when he stumbled upon relics thousands of years old. He immediately contacted the Treasure Trove Unit of Scotland, as is required by law if anyone finds archaeological relics of cultural or historical significance in the country, and he was soon joined by a team of expert archaeologists. Marius's initial discovery prompted a massive 22-day search at the site by professionals. The archaeologists were able to uncover a sword that dated back all the way to 1000 BC. They also found axle caps from a chariot and even a horse harness. Because the leather and wood were so perfectly preserved in the soil, experts were able to trace the straps that connected the rings and buckles on the horse equipment. It's actually a pretty incredible discovery from a largely ancient time. The man who originally stumbled upon the treasure trove camped out near the site with his hobbyist friends while the professional archaeologists investigated all the artifacts they could find. Today, the Bronze Age cache is sitting in the National Museum's collection center in the city of Edinburgh. It's one of the most impressive Bronze Age hoards ever excavated within Scottish borders. It's being labeled as a nationally significant find. World's oldest mattress. Of course, no archaeological examination could forget about the world's oldest mattress. That's right, archaeologists have now discovered the oldest bed ever made, and it came out of a cave in South Africa. So, how old is the oldest mattress? Well, until now, the oldest known use of human beings using plants as a mattress to sleep on is about 77,000 years ago. But this newest mattress inside the cave dates back to around 200,000 years ago. The ancient mattress comes from the Stone Age, but it was actually pretty comfortable considering the materials these prehistoric people had at hand. You didn't think cavemen slept on the hard cave floor, did you? The mattress was even designed to keep bedbugs from festering inside it. It was made with a mixture of grass and ash. Some of the grass is still growing just outside the cave. As for the ash, it was likely taken from the hearth to create a clean base for the bed that could control odor and repel insects. This is because cavemen knew that insects like bedbugs could not crawl through ash, and so they couldn't get into their bedding. The caves in which all of these artifacts were found is a pretty well-known cave near the border of South Africa and Eswatini that has extremely well-preserved evidence of human occupation that goes back 230,000 years. This was the home of real-life cavemen, not some Hollywood imitation, and it is strangely comforting to know how they lived, with a few creature comforts that make it clear that they were not so different from us. I hope you enjoyed these 10 amazing archaeological discoveries. Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you again for another amazing video. Thank you so much for watching.